low technology in a context where the needs of the students are driving the use of the technology. So it's not so much that she's using the technology, she's actually using the technology to kind of to support the students' language learning needs. And I just put the link there in the chat window. Thank you, Aya. Yeah, a really wonderful project, well worth checking out and worth replicating yourself if you are teaching ESP with students. Okay, just as a quick sort of summary here, what does that mean for you if you are teaching in a low resource context? I think the first step is this idea of establishing why you want to use the technology. What are the learning aims? I think learning through this project is a really good example of this. Yeah, the use of technology being driven by how she can support her taxi drivers and acquiring the language that they need. Starting small with one class and also asking your students what their needs are and also what technologies they have at their disposal. That's obviously where you need to start. Using, again, simple and appropriate technologies. You do not need high tech to be able to carry out effective lessons, as you all actually said in the poll at the beginning, using a regular. Making sure that the content is relevant and appropriate for your cultural context, a bit like the Indian thing as well. And then working within political reality. And by this I mean things like, you know, not expecting your students to bring expensive technologies to class if you're working in a situation with security challenges. A colleague of mine in Venezuela pointed this out to me a couple of years ago when he said, look, I can't ask my students to come to class with fancy smartphones if they haven't, because it's a security risk based on the target for money. I thought, you know, that's a really interesting point, something I've never actually thought of, living as I do in a very privileged environment here in Spain. So those kinds of things obviously will affect and a knock-on effect of the choices and the options that you have of where you are. And then the last point there, getting training and support. So joining institutions like Aya Tefl or joining a special interest group from the LTSOL or joining something like the Webhead, and you can get plenty of free training and support from like-minded teachers and indeed attending this kind of web conference. I'm probably preaching to the choir here, but you know what I mean. And you can find plenty of support online. So to revisit these, I think we've shown pretty conclusively that you don't need the latest technologies to carry out good tech-based lessons or activities. We very much work within the constraints and take advantage of the opportunities that we have. And then this idea of technology is too expensive, that you can use very low-cost technologies, I think. And certainly the India example and the Nervis example will show you. Okay, I think I might even be within time for this, which is fantastic. Just to say that these are the books that I've written to date, eight of them. We're running a monthly book raffle via our website, which is there on the slide, www.theconsultantsdashi.com. If you sign up for our newsletter, we're doing a monthly pulling a name out of the hat, and we will send you one of our books. The last month, which was April, the book, the winning book was ET Media Technology. And this month, I believe it's a book written by my colleague Gavin Dooney, which is the Internet Related Discussion. But we're doing one every month, so do feel free to come along and sign up for our newsletter, and you will automatically enter the book raffle. And here are my contact details. If you would like to ask me some slides or anything else about the presentation, please email me. There's a link there to some resources, and there's a tab there called Low Tech. And there you've got the links to the video I've just shown you and a couple of other projects carried out at international, national, and individual level that I just haven't had time to go into. So plenty more of these types of projects. You can read about them on that link there at the bottom. So it's exactly 9:30. I'm going to wind up there. Thank you very much for coming along. I hope you found this interesting. I hope you have